Hey friends, what's up and welcome back to this new episode on the channel. In this video we are checking out the new Sketch update, Sketch version 69. It comes with a brand new set of cool and amazing features and I will review them right now. Sketch 69 comes with three new key features. The first one is color variables. We will check this out right now. Next up is a totally revamped symbols management feature. And the last thing is some sort of design system management overview that I will check out with you together right now. So the first feature is color variables. What is the concept behind color variables? We will check it out right now. I will give you a little insight here. We have a nice little demo file prepared. And if you check out the fills on the right side, you already see that there are a few changes happening. So we have this icon right here that is kind of new. We have some sort of label right here that isn't normal for you Sketch 68 users. And we have some sort of active icon right here. Let's check out a normal color picker view. We see that in here there are a few colors defined, and as you can probably imagine already, those colors are color variables. And we have a few defined here for this document. And what we can do now, and the thought process and the concept behind color variables is that if you update this color on a certain position in your document and you update the color, it will change all of the colors that use the same color variable in your whole document. So let me try this out. Let me show you how this works. You right click on one of your color variables, and this in this example here I'm using the purple because the purple is widely used here in our document. And I hit edit. We can actually change the color itself. You see that the header is changing its color. And let's try out a color, maybe like something in this pink kind of area, like that. What we do now is we click on update and you will immediately see what will happen. Like, let's try it out. Update, boom. All of the colors that are in the document that use the color variable are changing. So we see it in so many different places. We see it on the font right here, on the label. The bottle color has changed. This little left-handed background has changed. The color of those icons here has changed, as well as those labels, buttons, and so on. So everything right here changed just because of a simple change of such a variable. Let's try it out again. I will just do another example and show you how it works. So you can just edit it and get a new color that you like and then hit update, and all of your fills that use the color variable are changing. I think that's such a cool and great feature, and for my design process this will help so much. So I can't really wait to just use this on a day-to-day basis because I'm super pumped about the feature. Of course, you can also create your own color variables. Just open the color picker symbol, and next up is just selecting a color that you like, that you enjoy, for example, like that. And next up, create color variable. Give it a name, like this is going to be like an olive green. Create, and boom, you got it in your document. Now, if you would like to create a color variable that is part of a set of color variables, like for example, the gradient or semi-transparent colors that we have right here, or the product colors, let me create a new product color because I want to show you the effect of it. I'm going to use this kind of light matte green, and I want it to be part of the product colors. So we just simply hit create. Then we call it products slash olive. So once we create it, you see it's just flipping down here in the products color variables group. And from there on, you can just use it all over your document and edit it on a single place, and it will update everywhere. So this is such a cool and great feature, and I'm as you probably already checked out in this video. I'm super pumped about it. So before we jump into the next feature, I want to tell you that there will be a live stream this week in which we test out all of the new features of the update in detail. This is just an overview video right here, but the live stream will be all of the features and things in detail. So the next feature I'm calling is symbol management. If we go up here and check out this part of our sketch UI, we see that there is no longer this kind of tabbed view of your components and your design, but they changed the whole symbol management. If you click on insert right now, you already see that there is a changed model popping up here, a changed dropdown. There is a search bar, so you can immediately check out, for example, you need an iPhone 10 frame or something like that. Just type it in and you get a little preview, the name, you get a little thumbnail right here, and it's just perfect. But there is something even better than that, and that's one of the key features of this update. It's this little icon, Browse All Components. Let's click on it. And you see that there is such a new window here popping up. How about that? What do you think about it? You can also just hit C on your keyboard and it's popping up. And what it gives you is a overview of all of the different symbols, styles, and color variables that you have. So in your first tab, you have all symbols. Then you have text styles, layer styles, and color variables. And there is such a cool way to use this window, because right now you can just, for example, use this first brand logo right here, because you maybe want to add the logo onto a certain place. So for example, I would like to add the logo into this left box right here to add some more branding, and I can just drag and drop it and place it in here. Next up, the window is popping back up, and I can even manage a few more of these symbols and add another button or whatever I want to do. So this is a pretty awesome feature, and especially because you can actually do kind of cool things with it. So let's go back to our desired layer, the header layer that is like used for all of the testing purposes in this video. Select it. And here we have the fills. And now if I hit C and open up our window, we can just browse the color variables. And then we have a whole set, whole variety of color variables right here. And maybe I would like to change the header color. How about just dragging over the color variable into the fill? Boom, it's changing. You can just drag and drop all of these color variables into the fill section and update your fills. It's so easy to use, and this new window, this new symbol management window, I think it's a pretty game-changing feature. I have used something similar like this, which was a plugin that I had to pay for, but this one, it's incredible. It will change your design workflow so much. And the last feature I would like to show you is also related to symbols and design systems, especially design system management. Let's check out our top bar right here. We see that there is a selection, a tabbed view. Right now we have our canvas selected, but we can show our components. And this is basically an overview of your symbols, but it's, if I click it, you will see what I mean. It's a design system created just using one click. So in here you have all your symbols, and they are organized, they are sorted by your groups that you created, and you can just check them out. You see the dimensions of it, and you can of course also interact with them, insert a symbol, edit the symbol source. So for example, maybe I want to change the checkbox that I selected right here. I can click on edit symbol source, and it will take me into my symbols page. So the symbols page is still there, it's still available, and you can even add new components into your design system. And for example, just to give you a quick example here, this is key feature number 2, something like that. So I have component slash key feature and component slash key feature number two. These symbols right here are also in the components group. And if I now go over into our components view, we see that there is a new key feature number two symbol sitting in the components group. So as easy as that, you can create symbols and sort them in your design management. So to check it out, to edit our newly created key feature number two, hit it edit symbol source. And as I said, it will take you to the symbol in your symbols page. There are way more things you can do right here. Change the layout of it, change some of the symbol source things, and you can just manage your symbols and your design system from here in a very easy and fast way. So what my process will look like right now is that I will use the symbols page to create and edit my symbols. And then if I want to manage them, if I want to change them, if I want to update them and get an overview of all of my symbols and my design system, I will go in here into the components view and check them out, manage them, organize them. From here, you can do so many cool things. I can even select three of them, for example, delete them, duplicate them, or group them, and just organize all of these symbols in here. I think that's a much, much better way of dealing with symbols, and Sketch really improved the symbols aspect so much by redesigning this little menu here, by getting rid of the tab view that we had here with the components and so on, and with the new symbol manager or symbol pop-up, you can just, as I said, insert them really quick, and using the new components view, you can manage your design system. I think that's such a big and awesome update, and I can't wait to use all of these cool new features in my day-to-day design process. I hope you enjoyed this new video. I hope you enjoyed this update. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section of this video, and we will definitely see us in the next episode. If you enjoyed it, hit the thumb up and subscribe to this channel if you haven't already. Thank you so much, friends, and we see us in the next one.